Heather, I beg of you, stay where you are. Beasts have been appearing out of nowhere, killing and tearing our family apart. Let the good Lord protect you. Don't you ever come here, Martha.
Surprised there's one in the cemetery.
Yeah. Son, it would appear that you're their hero.
Your runner got an answer to my telegram?
Looks like I was right. That mysterious cell in the mountains might have just what I need to upgrade my gauntlet.
The Lord works in mysterious ways.
Yeah, I was afraid you were gonna say something like that.
An occupational hazard, I'm afraid. I'll have Martha set you up with a fresh kit bag before you go.
That won't be necessary.
Son, part of being a hero is knowing when to let people help you. Even Jesus had his disciples.
Yeah, but one of them turned out to be kind of an asshole.
Speaking of which, when those monsters started showing up, we telegraphed the authorities, and they told us not to worry because Secretary Harrow was on the case personally.
You did us a real kindness last night. I hope you know we won't forget it.
Listen, next time, cut out the middleman and contact us directly. We're in Calico.
I hope you find what you're looking for, son. And let's pray that there'll still be people like us alive once you find it. Because these days, we really need some heroes. Godspeed, Mr. Rentier.
Next time, try following the map, kid.
Mr. Jesse!
Okay, all right.
Until that telegram came in, we all thought you were dead. Holy moly. This is where your father designed the first gauntlet. I've heard the stories about this place, but I never dreamed I'd visit it myself. Oh boy, we're about to re-explore history.
The gauntlet? Don't forget what we're here for. I need to upgrade it. This old lab should have what we need. What are we looking for?
Okay, I understand.
What are we looking for?
According to your father, the key to upping the voltage of your gauntlet is reconnecting those transmitters to the central current reservoir.
Oh, English, Verge.
Okay. I do a science-y thingy with your gauntlet, and you'll be running more charge than Edison himself could shake a circuit breaker at.
Got it. I'll clear the way. You take care of finding the central reservoir-y thingy.
I'll look for an alternative.
Still not willing to go for a ride? It's the fastest way.
Again, fastest, not safest, Mr. Jesse. I don't like the odds.
First-class ride.
been here 16 months now, and we are making progress. The harsh weather here has helped to accelerate the process. The lightning strikes have been helping us in our ongoing efforts to harness electricity. Soon, we will be able to use it as a weapon against our enemies. Such technology will give us the upper hand at last. Stay strong. Keep the faith. The future is nearly upon us.
Okay.
Mr. Jesse, hey!
Finders keepers.
Mr. Jesse, are they gone?
For now. That doesn't look like it's working.
All it needs is power. I was just about to turn on the generator over there when they appeared.
Yeah, I'm on it. Keep your head down.
The generator is in that house over there.
One tower can't deliver enough power to the reservoir. I think it's safe to say you'll need to power up those over there, too.
Let's get to it, then. Run to the walkway and I'll clear the way ahead. Those rocks look wobbly. Taking it.
Mr. Jesse, this way.
Birch, you okay?
That was close, Mr. Jesse, but I found a tunnel that might lead to the mines.
Keep moving. It probably connects up with the main lab. Do me a favor, though. Try not to get killed. That's tight.
Damn!
This is nice.
Shit. It's pretty damn steep.
Thank you.
March 1887. Gentlemen, the latest gauntlet tests have been very encouraging, and I appreciate your hard work and dedication to the cause. However, I must insist we continue to put a high priority on security. Under no circumstances should tests be performed in the field. Everything must be kept top secret. Our enemies must not see the fruits of our research until we can wield it against them. Otherwise, we risk exposing ourselves to great danger. The safety of the entire world is at stake.
Thank you. Jesse! Over here!
Let me guess. Ain't working?
The whole damn thing froze up! Holy hell! We've got company!
You do your magic. I'll take care of these guys. Let me guess. Ain't working?
The whole damn thing froze up! Holy hell! We've got company!
You do your magic. I'll take care of these guys.
The ice with the power of flame.
No shit, genius. Let's go.
things first, Mr. Jesse.
Yeah. Better safe than sorry.
We make a marvelous team, you and me, Mr. Jesse. With my brains and your... That didn't come out right.
Rentier! So glad to see you back. All cried out from Daddy's funeral. Made peace with the fact that you never told him how much you loved him. Oh, wait. You didn't do any of that, because William isn't dead. Instead, you and your band of grade-A chuckle fucks let the leader of America's goddamn vampire hunting agency turn into a goddamn vampire!
Mr. Secretary, sir, if it weren't for Director Rentier, we never would have found Felicity and...
Isn't that just fuckity great? Then I can assume you've got her severed head hidden behind your wiry dead ferret of a frame!
Secretary Harrow!
Dr. Blackwell, I can't believe I'm saying this. But as of right now, you are the fucking director of the soon-to-be-renamed Rentier Institute, with all the perks and privileges entitled therein. But for now, I want you to lock these sons of bitches up for high treason! And after that, you're gonna squeeze every bit of vital information out of the tick that's currently inhabiting the carcass of William Rentier. And once you're done, apply your own damn protocols and put a bullet in its head like you should have done days ago! Are you having some sort of female moment? I fucking want this fucking done right fucking now!
Would you allow me to present a counterproposal? You leave Calico right now and never come back, you lying, sweaty, lecherous, potty-mouthed, flatulent, ugly mustache creep!
You ungrateful swine!
You sure you want to dance that dance?
President Cleveland will know all about this right here. We're having dinner after a sweet-ass musical premiere none of you were invited to because you don't matter!
Jesus, I thought I'd shit myself.
Amelia, that was... potty mouth?
I'm about 90% adrenaline right now, Jesse, so maybe you save your critiques for when my legs stop shaking. Right now, you should go see your father.
Dr. Blackwell didn't punch his teeth out the way he treated her. After all the hard work she put building this place up from scratch.
Looked like she earned Rentier's respect the way she put that asshole in his place.
That's because Rentier respects balls. And now he knows who has the biggest set west of the Mississippi.
Survived from the manor's fall.
It's all my fault. Poor Martin.
Don't blame yourself, kid.
He was a friend. I promised to get him his gauntlet, but I was so busy, I just couldn't get to it. I should have resisted when Mr. Harrow sent him to Dickinson. It should have been me who went, not him.
Nerd.
You should have seen that ugly kiss when I fired his ass with this. Oh, just wait till we all get those gauntlets Virgil's working on. We're gonna win this war in a flash.
They're cunning beasts, Davis. We need to watch our backs. Never go alone. Revenge is a dish.
Best served hot?
Best served when you're still alive. So let's not get dead due to an overabundance of arrogance.
You gotta keep your guard up, Blue. Don't drop your dukes. Keep your elbows in. Gotta protect that breadbasket.
I think I got it, sir.